I'm hooked on Jesus. That would have been a great message today. I'm hooked on Jesus. But let me talk about addictions. Addiction has a negative connotation. I noticed in the entire same city of Corinth, there is this group, there's this home. They are so much addicted. They've addicted themselves to the ministry of the saints. Hooked on it. Now, they had issues with their theology. Now, they had issues with their knowledge base. Now, they had issues with their understanding. They had issues with their philosophy of ministry. We should tell ourselves the truth. We don't have to like it, but let's know it. I don't like the truth, but I need to know it. Not because I know I will change you, but let me even know the truth. Sometimes truth can be bitter. When you go to the doctor, you say, "Doctor, tell me the truth." And I don't want to hear it. Okay, you got cancer. Is that the truth? Yes. Let me know where I am. Nobody goes to the doctor and says, "Doctor, please lie to me. Please, do scan, do blood tests, but please tell me a lie. Don't tell me the truth about my health. I want to hear lies. Be honest. Just tell me a lie. Tell me, okay. You're a foolish person if you do that." You tell doctor, "Doctor, sir, take blood test. Do MRI scan. Please, sir, tell me the truth. And let me know where I am. I may now not do anything about it, but let me know the truth." Okay? The way you are going, your body weight is heavier. Go and cut down. You have heart attack if you don't stop eating. Then you know the truth. When you leave that place, you will now think in your car, "Should I stop? And I love mama." You now decide, "Okay, sweetheart," you tell your wife, "My dear, enough, not mama anymore at all." Based on the information. Am I communicating? That the same with pastors. Tell pastor, tell me the... I don't have to like it, but I need to know it. And if I must tell you today, we are not sinners. We are a cold, backsliding bunch of believers. We're not addicted to the things of God. We're not addicted to God at all. We're not addicted to Christian service. We are not. Not only are we complacent, we're laid back. We're not devoted, committed, or addicted. There was a house of Stephanus. The Bible says what? They were addicted. Look at that word now. Paul had to take knowledge of all the houses he saw. He said, "Abba, there's one household. They must have done some few things." In fact, the latter verses, he said, "They refreshed me regularly." You know, because I'm a preacher and I go around too often too, and I see, if you stay in one place, you think you're the best. Until you travel around, now know that there's another city called Cotonou, better than Lagos. You never know. You never know that there's Cotonou that arose at that. They obey the law. In Cotonou, they have light. You never know, you think your own is the best. So Paul said, "I've been to everywhere. I've seen different families. The house of Stephanas, they are different. Hey, they are addicted. They gave themselves. They, on their own, they said, 'We want to do this.' So they have refreshed me. So, therefore, can I counsel you? Submit yourself to such people." Why did he say that? They are the ones that will lead to heaven. Choose your leaders right. Don't follow people that are cold, because you will soon be cold. He said, "Follow people that are hot so that your life can be different." He said, "Follow such." Paul had to counsel. He said, "Submit yourself to such." That means there are other people. He said, "Don't submit yourself to them. Be careful, Lord. Submit yourself to these ones. These ones will lead you right. Those that are committed, that are devoted, that are passionate about the things of God." In Lagos, we have more church addicts than kingdom addicts. Lagos bishops and pastors have preached church more than kingdom. The kingdom is the mindset, the will, the rule and reign. The rule and reign of God over the spheres of men. Right now, the rule and the reign of God over the affairs of men. Over the what? Affairs of men. Be it politics, finance, sports, everywhere, including church. That's the kingdom of God. So those of you here going to politics like DG, who you should pray for, I support it. Go and push the kingdom agenda in that area. Go into the banking sector, push kingdom agenda in that area. Go to the health sector, push kingdom agenda. Not church, kingdom. What we have done is we push people to those spheres to push our church agenda. Church is part of the kingdom. We need kingdom addicts. I don't want you to be an addict for fodder. Be an addict for kingdom, for God, for Him, and Him alone. Look at the dictionary definition of the word addict. As both positive and negative connotation. It means somebody dependent on drugs or anything. Who is psychologically or physiologically dependent on a potentially harmful drug or a habit. Alcohol, pornography, internet. Let me read to you top 10. Top 10 in this, my note. Number one, coffee. Number two, gambling. I didn't know people have gambling addiction. They just are addicted to it. If you give them ₦1 billion, come back 2 months time, it's gone. Why? They've gambled. They just can't do without it. And there are different levels of Baba Jebu is also gambling, Abi. Naira bet is also Abi. You're just gambling. They're waiting for money. You want to work for something, you want money to come. You're a lazy man. You are giving money, looking for free money, free lunch. They are going to take all your money from you. Compulsive shopping. I discovered I am a compulsive shopper. I didn't realize it until my wife told me. Every time I travel, what I don't need, I must buy. So now I'm dealing with it. I told God, no way. So when I go around now, I close my eyes around. In Jesus' name, every knee shall bow. In Jesus' name, every knee shall bow. In Jesus' name, every tongue confess. In Jesus' name, every knee shall bow. Then I go this way, I say, just this knee. This knee should not bow. Let me know this knee. Compulsive! You buy things you don't need. Just think you have to buy. Just buy. Internet, number four. People are internet addicts. They just go on it. What are you looking for? I just want to solve. Just download. Just browse. They call it browse. A human being will leave his house. Why are you going to? I want to go and browse. But my dear, young lady, young man, wake up in the morning and go and browse. Before you go to bed, go to the browse. What are you browsing? Just browse. Okay, what are you looking for when you are browsing? I don't know. I'm just browsing. So the real thing you are doing is browsing, not looking for something. I'm just browsing. You have browsed everything, internet is crying, enough, you are browsing again. You are addicted. Food addiction is called obesity. Some cannot do without eating, their mouth cannot stop. If you see their mouth stop, they are angry. What are you doing? Find something to eat. Say they must do for food to eat. Food addiction. And it's a serious issue too. Serious. Of course, the one you know most is sex addicts. Sex. Some people are just sex addicts. These are the top 10 addictions in America and probably the world. They call women nymphs that just like sex. I watched a documentary once, they interviewed three of them. One of them said it's she feels bad. She even pays people to come and sleep with her. She goes around looking for, I want to sleep. Immorality. Because we as Christians, we have lower people with that kind of addiction. But the other areas where Christians are addicted, why we are not addicted to sex is because we understand the moral laws of God. That is bad. So we can easily deal with that area, but the other areas we're not dealing with. Alcoholism. Just drink it, not because they're not thirsty. Not that they're thirsty. You drink water when you are. You drink alcohol when you are what? You see? If you are thirsty, drink water. Alcohol cannot quench thirst. So why do you drink alcohol? To be high. It's addiction. Why should a human being want to be high? Well, if it's not insanity, why should you say, I want to be high? I need to be high. What will make me high? I'm going to be high to go and be. So when I come back home, I can be slapping everybody. Just keep falling in love with Jesus over and over and over and over again. No, you just know you can't control it. You just love Him so very much. You give, you love, you worship, you sing, you praise. Everything you do is for Jesus. You're just so much in love with this Jesus. So alcoholism is bad. Of course, controlled substance, heroin and cocaine is number 8. Heroin and then number 9 is marijuana. What we call Indian hemp in this part of the world. Finally, of course, nicotine. So these are all things. Nicotine is a particular substance different from all those things. Nicotine. Or something nicotine, but whichever one you want to call it. That's another substance. But then there are other things. When I use the word internet, some go there for pornographic purposes. That's also addiction. You're just addicted to it. But today I'm not speaking about the negative addictions. I'm speaking about what? The positive addictions. Can we be addicted to Jesus? It means to be an enthusiast. An addict is an enthusiast. That's a positive aspect. Somebody who is very interested in a particular thing and devotes a lot of time to it. What you are addicted to, you give time to. Can I ask you a question? How much time do you give to God? That's how you know if you're addicted to Jesus or not. You're not even there. I don't even consider you an admirer of Jesus. How much more an addicted person to Christ? Soap operas, they have addicts to that. Internet, social media, music, including praise and worship. Telemundo. I didn't know about Telemundo until just a few days ago. I was at a retreat. I never knew there was something called Telemundo. Somebody asked me, sir, do you live in this planet? They said, there's something called Telemundo that people cannot do without it. They say it's a TV soap opera that they hear, they like addiction. Telemundo. They won't dream about it. Telemundo. Telemundo. If you put the church program around Telemundo program, you may not have people come around. Or sports, football, Champions League, sports, yeah. You can get so hooked on it that it controls your mood and emotion. And it's bad. We know it. I acknowledge it. The day you lose, your wife knows that she has to pray more. If they don't go there, daddy, why? It's in a bad mood. Why should a game? You know, can we think? You know, it's a source matter. Why should a game influence my mood that much? One day I told myself, why should you not greet your wife well, talk to your children well, because Chelsea, am I on the Chelsea staff? Do they pay money? Do they pay money? Who are, I beg, you won't control me. Sin shall not have dominion over you. Chelsea, you don't have dominion over me. Amen. Even though, as I said it, it's a matter of confession. Praise God. More often than not, addiction is used as in a negative way today. And so what it does is it kills the enthusiasm of people towards the things of God. It kills it. More often than not, that's what we use it. We use it more negative than more positive. Because we do not have people that are positively addicted or devoted. The word addiction is negative in connotation. The word devotion is positive. But they mean the same thing. The same thing. Devotion or addiction. The same thing, pretty much. Matter of semantics. Matter of semantics. Some call it habit. Some say excessive use of something or excessive practice of something. So if you tell me I'm excessively practicing the love of God, I want to. I'm excessively reading my Bible, I want to. I'm excessively praying, I want to. I'm excessively worshiping God, I want to. You say, no, it's too much now. Just worship God for 30 minutes. Why are you doing 3 hours? Yeah, this is SU, you put an SU Egbe Union. You know, there's nothing wrong with it. So they make us feel bad when we love God so much. Because nobody can outlove God and outdo God in giving. You can't. You are not addicted to something if you can control yourself. You are not. Anything you can control, then you're not addicted to it. It's, what addiction means that you can't control the urge to do that thing. So if you look at our commitment to Jesus and our devotion to the things of God, you will agree with me, friends, that we're not addicted to Jesus or to the ministry of the saints, like the house of Stephanas. We're not. We're very far from it. Rather, we analyze things too often. We criticize things too often. We have a I don't care attitude towards the things of God. Nobody cries when the church is empty on Sunday. Nobody cries.
Whatever. That's our business. Who cares?
There's this thing. Nobody cries when his team is losing. You cry. So if you have a team, and the team is the Jesus team, and you sense that your Jesus team is losing, you should weep, you should cry. It should affect your moods. But if you can go to bed and sleep and see nothing wrong, then there's something wrong somewhere. That means you don't feel what heaven feels. You know when God said that for every soul that comes to Christ, there is joy in heaven. Can I ask you a question? For every soul that leaves Christ, what do you think will be in heaven? Just reverse it. Sadness. For Christ to say, I celebrate the coming of every soul through salvation. That means it bleeds when souls leave him through rejection, through backsliding. So how do we feel when Christians backslide? Whatever. How do we feel when they don't come to church anymore? Whatever. And you say you love God. When a team is losing, they sack the coach. Because we're talking about what? Our reaction to the things of God. To know whether we love God, check the way you react to the things of God. Very simple. And what matters to God is not the pew you're sitting on, but the person that sits on the pew. What matters to church is a beautiful church, but the people that come to church. What matters to God is not the microphone, but the worship we do with the microphone. So if we're not worshiping, and we have the best microphones in church, heaven is sad. There is joy in heaven over one soul that repents. May I rephrase, there is sadness in the presence of God over one that lives. And people are living faith. Why should you be happy when your father is sad? Why should you be glad when he's sad? Make him happy. Make him happy. Not me. I don't care. Care about him. Make him happy. Love. Do the things that will excite him. There's sinners out there who need the salvation of Christ. The synonyms of addiction are devotion, zeal, enthusiasm, and salt. God wants us to be kingdom addicts. Be devoted to the ministry and service. Of course, the opposite of addiction is to be laid back, to be cold, which speaks about backsliding state of our faith. Many of us, what I do every year end is to appraise myself throughout the year. I ask myself, how have I fared? My walk with God, my walk with my wife, my walk with my children, my walk with my members. I try to evaluate my relationships every year. Have I loved the way I should love? Have I forgiven? Have I made impact sufficiently? I start with God, then to my family next. Because God comes first in my life, my family is next. My family is not above God, and my wife knows that. And I'm not saying this because I'm a pastor. I'm saying this because I'm a Christian. Did you hear me? I'm not saying this as a pastor. I'm saying this as a Christian. I'm first and foremost a Christian before I become a pastor. My family is after my God. Unapologetically, unashamedly, I say that.
For more of Reverend Yomika Sally's messages, watch him on YouTube, Reverend.YomikaSally. For inspirational quote on Twitter, follow at Yomi_Kasali and our Facebook page, www.facebook.com/FotaChurch.